we will look at the end of chapter one and then a little bit at a portion of chapter two this morning for a few moments before we partake of our Holy Communion. What we want to use as a thought from profession to performance.
Well, come on.
From profession to performance. If you've read your Bibles, I'm going to keep saying that, amen. I can forget about the rest of this sermon I'm here. I like that part, Brother Charles. If you've read your Bibles, you will know what our marching orders are. What God has called us not only to be, but what God has called us to do. And if you've really read your Bibles, God has designed the sacred text to establish God as our one and only true source of life, of supply, of protection, of salvation, and of love. The book of James is a book of wisdom literature. It provides so much for us in moral teaching, amen. It provides instruction for us. It provides us, it gives us practical knowledge and ways of living in a difficult world, but still living for God. And this book is written to the dispersed Jewish Christians that were outside of Palestine. The writer wanted to write to those dispersed people and let them know that they are not alone. And not only do they have God with them, but there are some responsibilities that each and every one of us have if we dare to call ourselves followers of Jesus Christ. So he's given us these words, these words of instruction, these words of teaching, these words that help us to live Christian lives, the words that help us to live holy lives, words that help us to separate ourselves and make it known to the world that I'm not living like everyone else. I don't walk like everyone else, but I walk with the mark and the seal of the Most High God. And in this text, we are called to remember that, you know, it's not enough just to read the Bible. Amen. It's not enough just to come in here on Sunday morning and sit up under the reading of the worship leader and the pastor and hope something washes over us and seeps into our skin, amen. You know, there's no vibranium coming in, amen. It won't seep into your skin and give you any... I'm assuming y'all saw Black Panther. Amen. The spoilers are over, amen, amen. We spoiled it today. But there's no magic potion that allows the word to seep into your skin and produce life. But instead, we have to be intentional. We have to be deliberate. We have to have upon our minds that we will not only hear the word, but we also must be doers of the word. You know, we read scripture every morning. I try to put scripture in places that you didn't know it was. Like the call to worship is always scripture, amen. Come straight from the Bible. We don't make it up, amen. We don't get it from Maya Angelou or Langston Hughes. We get it straight from the Bible so that you can be speaking the word. And I believe that if you hear the word and speak the word, then you might trip into doing the... backwards into doing the word.
I'm sorry, John.
Are you good? Okay.
Amen. Jesus gave us our instructions before he left this earth. Jesus said, blessed are they, rather are those who hear the word of God and obey it. This is a beatitude in the Gospel of Luke. It's outside of the Sermon on the Plain, amen, but Jesus says, amen. Jesus says particularly that blessed are those who hear the word of God and obey it. Not just hearing the word, because we have to do more than just hear the word. We hear a lot of things that we don't act upon. Amen. We hear that we ought to stop eating this and stop eating that. We hear that we ought to stop putting this on our bodies or in this in our bodies. We hear a lot of things that we don't act upon, but the word of God does not give us that luxury. The word of God says from the words of Jesus that you will be blessed not only when you hear the word, but when you obey it, or when you follow it, when you go out and do that which the word of God says for you to do. Why is that an issue for us? Book of James is different from many of the other epistles because we don't know exactly who James was writing his book to. You know, in Paul's letters, we know that it was many of them were written to a particular congregation or faith community. And we know that Paul would answer questions. So there were indicators in his letters that would say concerning fasting or concerning communion or concerning the assistance to the poor. This is what I am telling you. But James does not give us those same types of indicators, which the scholars tell us means that James's writing was to a general church. It was to a general church, not necessarily to a specific church, but it was for a general church and for all the churches that would come up in the future. And I don't know if you realize this, but way back in 60 AD, someone knew that even the church in 2018 would have people who would hear the word and would not do the word. Even in 2018, there would be 100 folks in Centennial listening to a word from the worship leader, listening to a word from the pastor, and then they would go out to brunch or to watch the game or to go shopping and would not do anything that was mandated by the word. Now, how did the writer know that there would come a time when people, men and women, when we have to be reminded not only are you to hear the word of God, but you are to obey it, and that is where your blessing would come from. That's wisdom, y'all. Wisdom is that which someone who has experience, amen, someone who has experience knows and is trying to tell those with no experience, this is what I've seen. I've seen a lot in my life. I've seen a lot in my day. You don't know because you haven't experienced, but if you listen to me, I'll help you avoid some of the pitfalls. Lord, have mercy. I'll help you avoid some of the stumbling blocks. I'll help you avoid some of the traps that you may fall into. We have to be doers of the word. The scripture starts out by telling us, you must understand this, my beloved. Let everyone be quick to listen. Now, this is what the word says. Be quick to listen and slow to speak. Lord, have mercy. And even slow to anger, for your anger does not produce God's righteousness. We have to be careful about our responses to these stimuli. Amen. We have to be careful about our responses to something that someone says that you don't like. The scripture is telling us be a doer of the word. And what is the word telling us. It's telling us to be quicker to listen. We ought to be doing a whole lot more listening than we do speaking. I wish I had a witness this morning. We ought to be listening, not only listening for what our brothers and sisters say, but we also ought to be listening what the Spirit is saying. And I don't know if you realize this, but even when you're engaged in conversation, the Spirit of God ought to be speaking to you. The Spirit of God speaks to your heart. The Spirit of God speaks to your mind. The Spirit of God gives you understanding and says, don't walk that way. Don't stop right there. Don't continue down that course. And you ought to hear the voice of God in everything that you do. We have to be doers of the word. Quick to listen, slow to speak, and slow to anger. For your anger does not produce God's righteousness. Therefore, rid yourselves of all sordidness and rank growth of wickedness, and welcome with meekness the implanted word that has the power to save your souls. And then in verse 22, he goes on to say, but be doers of the word and not merely hearers who deceive themselves. You know, I was watching boxing last night. Don't judge me. Amen. Somebody else was watching it too. Amen. And I was thinking about being a hearer and a doer. And every time the round ends, the boxer will go to a corner of and he would sit down and he would have his trainer in his face telling him, do this and do that. Don't do this. Stay off the ropes. Don't get too close. Keep throwing your jab. But then the boxer would go out and do everything that his trainer told him not to do. And I'm wondering if sometimes if we don't do that even in the church. God's word tells us to go a particular course, and then we look with our human eyes and we do the exact opposite of what God's word has told us to do. Lord, have mercy. But I was looking at that and I was wondering, I was thinking, well, you know, the trainer has a different perspective than the fighter. Amen. The fighter is getting hit with rights and lefts. Y'all know the story. Lefts and rights. And so he may not all be able to see from a different perspective what the trainer can see. And that's why we need wisdom literature. Because the wisdom says, I've seen this fight from a different perspective. I've seen it from the 8,000 foot view. I've seen what you cannot see. I've heard what you cannot not hear. I've experienced what you never experienced before. So listen to me and I will show you the way. We have to not only be hearers, but we have to be doers. You know, I was looking at that match and I was saying to myself, you know, if he listens, then he may get out of this without being knocked out. Amen. But sometimes we don't listen. We stumble right through life not taking the advice that we've been given by someone who's wiser and much more knowledgeable than ourselves. What James is trying to get us to understand is that there is a difference between passive faith and active faith. We are called to have active faith. Amen? We are called not just to have faith and say, well, I have faith, it's in my heart, it's good, it's mine, don't bother me. But instead, our faith ought to produce some actions that let the world know that we have been touched by Jesus, by his blood, and by his righteousness. We ought to have some actions that show that we did not deserve God's love through Jesus Christ, but he gave it to us as a free gift. And when I have come to the point where I can't help myself no more, I have to show somebody else
of faith. We cannot just go along in this life listening to the word, but we have to be doers of the word. What does the word tell us to do? The word tells us to have a relationship with God. Do you have a relationship with God? The word tells us to repent of our sins. Have you repented of your sins? Have you set on a course to lead a new life? Have you done the word of God? You know, the word of God gives us a lot that we are to do. You know, the word does not just say, use these scriptures to tell someone else off. Amen. It doesn't say use the scripture to prove your point, to appear superior or more knowledgeable to someone else. But the word of God is convicting to all of us. Lord, have mercy. You are not ever read scripture and not see an area where you too could grow or where you too could get closer to God, where you too could walk more like Jesus. The word of God is not only convicting, but it's instructional. It gives us a practical life application to help us navigate through this difficult world. Amen. The word of God gives us encouragement. The word of God gives us empowerment. The word of God gives us assurance. The word of God gives us hope. And I don't know about you, but I need some hope in this life. When the way of the word is bearing down on me, I need a reminder that yes, God is with me, and yes, we do have the victory in Jesus Christ. We have the victory because Jesus paid it all. We have the victory because Jesus is not dead, but Jesus is alive, sitting at the right hand of the Father. We have hope because His presence, His power is still in the world today. We have hope. We have to be doers of the word. He said, if any are hearers of the word and not doers, they are like those who look at themselves in a mirror. For they look at themselves and on going away immediately forget what they were like. That's like when you with your friends, you hanging out and you see somebody go look in the mirror and they turn around and they still have something on their face. You wonder, did you see, Lord? You wonder, what did you see? Because you came back to me the same way that you left me, amen? And I don't know about you, but every time we come into this place, I remind us, let's not go out the same way that we come in. Let's be about change. Let's grow closer to God. Let's walk more like Jesus. Let's not stay the same. Let's not keep doing the same and saying the same and acting the same and punishing the same and hating the same. Let's do something new. Let's do something different because God reveals a whole lot about us through God's own word. He says, it's like a person that goes and looks in the mirror and immediately forgets what they were like. But those who look into the perfect law, the law of liberty, and persevere, being not hearers who forget, but doers who act, they will be blessed in their doing. I love how the writer adds the blessing on to this instruction. He's saying we must be hearers and doers. Not either or, but both and. Amen? And to top it all off, I promise that God will bless you if you do both of these. If you hear the word and do the word. Amen? What the writer is trying to get us to understand is that without actions, what is our faith? Can you have faith without actions? Can you have faith without works of piety and works of mercy and works of justice and works of love. What is your faith if you have not works? You know, we got a lot of bad weather over the last several weeks, and somebody was making fun of me because my car was still dirty. Amen. And I wanted to respond in one way, but I didn't. And I offered that person to go ahead and wash it for me. And I'm sure you know how that went. But I was always one of those weird people that, you know, why do you keep washing your car? It's just gonna get dirty again. Amen. So, you know, this person was making fun of me and I wouldn't wash my car. And I looked out there this morning, it was dirty again. Amen. And I thought about that in the context of our communion ritual today. We are prepared to come to the table. And some people don't take communion often because they say, I'm not ready for that type of observance. I'm not ready to take communion. I'm not right yet. My heart's not right yet. I'm not going to take communion because I'm like the car. I'm just going to get dirty again. Lord, have mercy. We all know people like that. We all know people who don't want to get closer to God because they know that they're just going to get dirty again. But even in the context of our scripture, Jesus told us to come to his table as often as you shall. So even if you think you're going to get dirty again, you ought to still come to the table, not just being hearers of the word, but also being a doer of the word. Coming to the table, kneeling down and confessing your sins, saying, Lord, forgive me. Lord, I did what I should not have done. Lord, I did not do what I should have done. But Lord, I want to grow closer to you. I want to live like you want me to live. I want to walk like you want me to walk. And I don't care if I get dirty again. I know a man who can clean me up. I don't care if I get hurt again. Whether you don't have a job, whether you don't have money, whatever it is in your life, Jesus can fix it. As we prepare to leave this place, I want you to be a hearer of the word. If you read your Bible, amen. Now let's take the if off. When you read your Bible, hallelujah, somebody. When you read your Bible, when you open it and find the strength, when you open it to find the salvation, when you open it to find the love, then go and be a doer of the word. May God bless you and keep you. Would you stand as we extend an invitation?